Let us continue the slides now. So in the last question we have seen, that is if you multiply or divide, if you multiply or divide any other equations, what will happen in the solution? So if you multiply or divide any non-zero number to an any equation on both of the sides, on both of the sides, definitely the solution will be same. Okay, so that is we have proved in the last example, right? And look at the next example. The cost of a table is 100 more than half of the cost of chair, and write this statement as a linear equation two variables. So here the two variables are cost of a table and cost of a chair. We don't know how much they are, so let us take this cost of the table is rupees x, okay. And next, the cost of the chair, let us take this as rupees y, okay. And what statement are given here? The cost of the table is, that is x is, so x equal to 100 more than, so 100 more than, so 100 more than means 100 plus, that is 100 more than, 100 plus, so 100 plus half of the cost of the chair, half of, so 1 by 2, so half of cost of chair, so cost of chair will be y, so that's all, okay. So just bring it into left hand side, so this will become x, and replace it to your left hand side here, minus 1 by 2 y equal to 100, okay, and make a cross multiplication here, so 2x minus y and divided by 2 equal to 100, okay. Then now make a cross multiplication again to the right hand side, so multiply 2 with this, so 100 into 2, so this will become 2x minus y equal to 100 into 2, 200. So 100 into 2, 200. So that is the required equation. So that is the required equation of this example, right? Right. Look at the next one. A fraction becomes 1 by 4. A fraction becomes 1 by 4 when 2 is subtracted from the numerator, right? And 3 is added to the denominator. So represent the situation in the form of linear equation. And also they are asking to find out the solution, two solutions they are asking to find. So fraction means it is the form of numerator and denominator, right? So here this fraction becomes how much? 1 by 4, okay. So this fraction becomes 1 by 4 when 2 is subtracted from the numerator. So the numerator is x here, so 2 is subtracted means, so x minus 2, okay, and 3 is added to the denominator, so denominator is y, so 3 is added to the denominator, so we have to put plus 3 here, okay, plus 3, so x minus 2 divided by y plus 3 equal to 1 by 4, okay. Now simplify this, make a cross multiplication. So when you make a cross multiplication, what will happen? So 4 into x minus 2 equal to, here already 1 is there, so 1 into y plus 3. Okay. Now multiply 4 inside now. So 4x minus and 4 into 2 again, 4 to the 8 equal to, so when you multiply 1 with inside, it will become y. So this will become y plus 3, right? So now transpose y left hand side, so 4x minus y equal to, so already 3 is there, and transpose 8 into right hand side, it will become plus 8. So 4x minus y equal to 8 plus 3, 11. So that is the required equation for this example. And they are asking to find out two solutions here. Okay, so we can put any other value. Okay, if you put x equal to 0, means what will happen? So now this equation becomes 4 into 0 and minus y equal to 11. The 4 into 0, 0 only. So minus y equal to 11, that is y equal to minus 11. So here the one of the solution is 0 comma minus 11, right? So that is the one of the solution. And for one more solution, put y equal to 0 and find out the value of x. So if you put y equal to 0, means what will happen? So 4x minus 0 equal to, so 4x equal to 11, 4x minus 0 equal to 11. So 4x minus 0, 4x only. So 4x equal to 11, therefore x equal to 11 divided by 4. So another solution, so x value 11 by 4 comma y value 0. So 11 by 4 comma 0, right? These are the two solutions, right? What is another one? So Mrs. Sharma lost her purse containing 50 rupee and 10 rupee notes amount to rupees 1500 in a shop. So next day, shopkeeper found the purse during dusting. He immediately went to Mrs. Sharma's house and returned the purse and rupees. Mrs. Sharma appreciates the shopkeeper for his act. So represent the situation as an equation and draw the graph. So here they told a story. Okay. So we no need the story under, we need the statement of the equation. Okay. So what is the statement of the equation here? So in a purse, how much rupees are there? Rupees 1500 totally. So this is the combination of 50 rupees and 100 rupees. Right. So we are going to represent this situation as a linear equation. That's all. So that is the statement of the equation. So we don't know how much 50 rupees are there. So let us going to take that number of 50 rupees. Okay, it's nothing but x. Okay, yes, x is nothing but, so number of, so n, number of 50 rupees. So number of 50 rupees, right? And y also you can take number of, so number of 100 rupees. Okay, number of 100 rupees. So here 50 rupees and 100 rupees, and this one is nothing but 1100, the total amount. Okay, that is, you can multiply these two, that's it. 50 into x plus 100 into y equal to, so equal to how much totally? 1500. Okay, so 50 rupees x plus 100 rupees into y equal 1500. So that is the required linear equation for this example. So they are asking to find out solutions, and also they are asking to draw the graph also. So first to find any two solution and plot it on the graph sheet and then connect them. Okay. So that is a procedure to draw the graph of this linear equation. Okay. And look at the next one. So sum of the two numbers is 8. And write this in the form of a linear equation in two variables. Also draw the line to the given equation. Okay. So sum of the two numbers. So we don't know the two numbers. So let us take one number as x and another number as y. So x plus y equal to 8. So that's all. So sum of the two numbers equal to 8. So write the situation in the form of linear equation. So that is a required linear equation. And they are asking to find, that is draw the line given to by the equation. The line means nothing but a graph. Okay, because The form of a linear equation is nothing but a straight line only. Already you know that. So they're asking to draw the graph only here. So for drawing the graph, we need solutions, minimum two solutions. Okay. So suppose if x equal to 0 means what will happen? So x equal to 0 means, so substitute here. So 0 plus y equal to 8. Therefore, y equal to, so 8 minus 0, that is y equal to 8. So what is the first solution now? So x equal to 0 means y equal to 8. So this is one of the solution. And for another solution, put y equal to 0 and find out. So if you put y equal to 0 means what will happen? So this equation becomes now, so x plus y value 0 equal to 8. Therefore, x equal to, again, here 8 minus 0. Therefore, x equal to 8. So here, what is the solution now? So x value 8 and y value 0. So 8 comma 0. So here also 8 comma 0 and here also, sorry, here 0 comma 8, here 8 comma 0. Both are different, right? So plot it on the graph sheet and then connect them with a straight line. So that is nothing but line graph. Okay. And I think everyone of you understood what all we have seen in today's video. So up to now we have seen about a linear equation. So what is linear equation and structure of linear equation and how to find out the solution of the linear equation and how to check the given solution is a solution of a linear equation or not, and how to draw the graph of the linear equation and how to find out the unknown value when the solution of a linear equation given. So everything, this kind of algebraic sums we have seen, and also applications, and we have seen how can we convert the real life situation in the form of a linear equation into variables. Okay, so up to now today's class we have seen so many applications, and we have converted into a linear equation two variables, and wherever they're asking to draw the graph, just to find out minimum two solutions and plot in the graph sheet and connect them. So definitely the form of the graph will be the straight line because it is a linear equation. So graph of the linear equation always a straight line. So your graph is not a straight line means, so the your solution only wrong. Okay. So just to go through once again the slides, and if you have any doubt, just ask me. I will clear your doubt. Right. So let us meet into next session. Thank you.